from the train's models to the railroads. You can customize basically everything in the train controller asset. In this tutorial you will learn how to customize the asset to suit your project needs. The train controller asset is available at the Unity Asset Store. Links in the description below. Trains can be saved on your project as train prefabs or as train profiles. As shown in the previous tutorial, both prefabs and profiles can be used by the train spawner to add trains to your scene. The main difference between them is that train prefabs have all the pros and cons of Unity's prefab system. However, train profiles requires much less disk space, being the optimal solution to reduce your project's storage and memory usage. To create a train prefab, start by adding an empty game object to your scene and resetting its position to the world origin. Then select a locomotive prefab and drop it underneath this object to set it as a child object in the hierarchy. Repeat this same process to add the selected wagons to your train. At this point, you'll notice all the wagons are positioned on top of each other. To recalculate the wagons' positions, first, they need to be connected to the locomotive. To connect them, select the locomotive in the hierarchy window and add the wagons into the wagons list, located under the wagons tab of the locomotive component. Now click the connect wagons button, and the wagons positions will be recalculated automatically. To save your train as a prefab, select the parent object on your scene and drop it into the desired folder. Now let's take a closer look at the train profiles. Train profiles are scriptable objects that contains references to the locomotive and wagons prefabs that composes the train. To create a custom train profile, right-click on a folder and go to Create WSM Game Studio Train Controller Train Profile. Then select your custom profile and drop the desired locomotive and wagons prefabs into the inspector. And that's it. Your custom train profile is ready to be used by the train spawner. Ready to use locomotives and wagons prefabs can be found under the prefabs folder. These locomotives and wagons can be added to your railroad by using the train spawner. Or they can be used to create trains, like shown in the previous section. If you have custom or third-party locomotive and wagon models, you can use the custom wagon creator to convert them into ready-to-use prefabs. It can be found at WSM Game Studio, Train Controller, Utilities, Custom Wagon Creator. It works by using a custom wagon profile as a guide to set up and build the prefabs properly. To convert your model into a prefab, start by selecting a profile, then select your model, select a name and click on Create. The resulting object will be added on your scene. Select this object and drop it into the desired folder to save it as a prefab. Custom wagon profiles are scriptable objects that defines which type of railroad cart will be created and which parts should be used on its composition. Profiles can be reused to create multiple prefabs as long as they share common characteristics such as cart's length, same couplers and wheels positions, and other common shared parts. Sample parts are included in the asset, but you can also create custom parts by duplicating the existing samples and using them as a starting point. To create a custom wagon profile, it is recommended to duplicate a sample profile and use it as a starting point, adjusting only the settings and parts that are different from the original profile. You can also create profiles from scratch by right-clicking on a folder and going to Create WSM Game Studio Train Controller Custom Wagon Profile. However, you will have to set all settings and parts references manually, which will require a bit more effort than duplicating a sample profile. Now let's take a look on how to customize the railroads. Which type of rails is generated by the railroad builder is defined by a mesh generation profile. For example, if I select one of the profiles from the cable car extension and regenerate the mesh, you will notice the railroad will be immediately replaced by cable car rails. Mesh generation profiles are scriptable objects that defines which models and materials are used as base for railroad generation. They also define which colliders and physics materials should be applied on physics-based rails, and which railroad stop blocks should be used at the start and the end of the railroad. Physics-based railroads require colliders in order to work properly. But spline-based railroads don't. For custom physics-based profiles, it is highly recommended to use the same colliders and physic material applied to the sample profile. Since generation profiles are scriptable objects, you can create custom profiles by duplicating the existing samples or by right-clicking on a folder and using the Unity file creation menu. Once you've created your custom profile, you can assign custom models and materials to be used as base for railroad generation. Custom rail models should be short. Just like the sample rail models included in the asset. You need at least one custom rail segment model, but for performance optimization, it is recommended to use multiple LODs. Ready-to-use railroad switches, also known as turnouts, can be found under the prefabs folder. However, in some situations the sample prefabs may not fit, and you may need to create a custom turnout for that specific section of your railroad. The creation of a custom turnout is a two-step process. The first step is creating and baking the railroad segments you need. I'll use the railroad builder to create the rail segments, and the mesh baker to export them as prefabs. For this example, I'll create an intersection shaped like an Y. I'll start by creating and baking a rail segment slightly curved to the left. Then I will repeat the same process to create a rail segment slightly curved to the right. The second step is converting those railroad segments into a turnout prefab. So I'll start by dropping the rail prefabs into the scene and opening the turnout creator window at WSM Game Studio, Train Controller, Utilities, Railroad Turnout Creator. Then, I'll select the rail segments that will be used to create the turnout, select a name for the turnout prefab, and click on Create. By default, the rail segments on the scene will be replaced by an instance of the new turnout. The turnout prefab will be saved on the target folder and can be reused on different sections of your railroad. Now let's assume you want to connect this turnout on the end of your railroad. This can be done quickly by using the railroad connect target operation. You can also connect railroads on the end of which turnout rails by using the connect target operation of the baked rail segments located inside the turnout. As you can see, the train controller asset can be customized to fit your project needs. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to check out the asset store links in the video description.